So I decided to follow it, and it led me here to the gold pot of awards that we're going to give out here tonight to Cambridge FFA members. Like Drake said, my name is Ryan Reeverts, and I currently serve as the Illinois FFA State Reporter. I reside from the Byron FFA chapter in Byron, Illinois, just south of Rockford. And tonight, to start off by a show of hands, if I can see if anyone in this room has ever gotten stuck in a vehicle, whether that be in snow, mud, traffic, or anything, go ahead and raise your hands. All right, I see a lot of hands. That either means that we have a lot of bad drivers or there's been some really interesting situations. So, tonight I'm going to tell a story about a time in which I got stuck. Now let's take a trip and back in time to the summer of my sophomore year of high school. On our family farm, I am the fifth generation, and we designate a lot of acreage towards grass and alfalfa hay production in order to feed our beef and dairy cattle. One afternoon, it was my job to go out and check one of our hay fields for two things: if it was mature and ready to be cut, and if the field conditions would allow us to go in and cut the hay crop. Now mind you, in north central Illinois, where I'm from, usually we get about 3 to 4 inches of rain each month during the summer. It's a very sensitive mic. Wow. Now this particular month that I was going out to check the hay field, we had received about 6 inches of rain so far. So that caused for some very slippery situations. So I headed out in our old farm truck and checked the hay field, and so when I got out there, I decided to make one lap around the perimeter of the field. I'm gonna try this. Can everyone hear me? Awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and put this mic down. All right, sorry about that. Now, like I said, I got out of the field and made one perimeter pass around the outside of the field to see if the conditions were good. As I went around the outside perimeter, I began to get more and more confident that the field conditions would allow us to go in and harvest the hay crop. But before I went back up to the farm office and gave my father my scouting report for the day, I decided I would make one pass right through the dead center portion of the field, see if those field conditions were as well suitable for us to harvest the hay crop. As I began to drive through the center of the field, I got further and further, yet the conditions began to deteriorate. I about got to the dead center portion of the field, and I got to the point in which the old farm truck that I was driving, even in four-wheel drive, was no match for the northern Illinois loamy mud, and would not budge one more inch further. Now, at this point in time, I had no idea what I was going to do. So I decided to step out of the truck, assess the situation I was in, and figure out some potential options to solving this problem. Number one was to put the truck in neutral, get behind it, and try to push it out of the ruts that I just made, which would mean that thunder and lightning would have to be out of the way. Number two was to go ahead and go back out to the home farm, to the barn, grab a tractor and a chain, head back out to the farm, hook it up, and pull the truck out. Number three was to go ahead and take those 2x4s and 4x4s that were in the back of the farm truck, put those in the butts that I made in the field, and try to aid the truck with traction to crawl itself out. Or number four was to go ahead and get back in the truck, put it over here, give it a little bit of fuel, and see if that Chevy power that got me into this mess could get me out of this mess. All while I was thinking of these possible solutions to the problem, I also thought about one thing. How exactly was I going to approach my dad about this situation? You see, I didn't want to cause his blood pressure to rise or have him give me a lecture, which would cause me, my blood pressure to rise as well. So I figured out the best possible solution to the problem was to go back up to the farm, grab a tractor and a chain, head back out to the field before my dad knew exactly what I was up to, and pull the truck out myself. So that's exactly what I did. Except as soon as I got back out to the field, hooked the tractor up, and got the chain hooked around the front axle of the truck, I realized one other thing. I was going to need one other person to steer the truck as I pulled it out of the rut so that I did not damage anything on the farm truck. So I pulled my cell phone out, called my dad, and told him exactly what happened. Surprisingly enough, he wasn't very frustrated about the situation. He simply said that, "Ryan, you wouldn't have known what the field conditions were unless you went out there and checked them just like you did." So my dad came out to the field, got in the farm truck, and we pulled it out and got it back up to the farm near the office. Now, we had a newly made mud bog in the middle of my beautiful hay field, but we got the truck out. See, that day I simply had to step on the cab, assess the situation I was in, figure out the best solution to the problem by weighing my options, and simply think outside the rut in order to get the job done.